In order to create a new Angular project, if you do not have already npm installed, just go to this website, which is npmjs.com/get-npm, and download download and install npm for your OS version, whether if you are using Mac or Windows. In the Windows operating system, so all you need to do is to install npm. So this is the first and the required part. Next, once it's installed, and to check if npm is correctly installed, open your terminal and just type npm -v to check the version. So for me, the installed version is 6.14.6. And then you go to your workspace using the command line, or just open your command line in your workspace. And all you need to do, actually it's really quite easy, is ng new and your project name. Let's say, for example, test project name, and you click enter here. NPM will ask you whether if you want to add the Angular routing. Yes, of course we need it. And now here we need to precise which styling sheet format we need to, or we would like to use. I recommend you using the SCSS. It's not valid. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, the name was not correct. And let's call it just test. And let's do it again. Yes, I want the routing and use the SCSS. So now npm will create the project. And here we see that we are creating the readme file, the edit config, the git ignore, and so on and so forth, the package.json, and now we are installing all the packages. I'm sorry for making you wait, because it's gonna take a bit time. My internet connection those days is a bit bad. So instead of waiting, I will open our frontend project and explain to you what's gonna be generated. So what will be created is we will have this src file, and we will have the app. Inside the app, let's close everything. Yeah, inside the app, by default, we will create the app module.ts and the app component ts, the spec, the SCSS, and the HTML file. And this is our app routing module.ts. And we will have also all those files, which is the index.html, styles.css. This is for the global styling. We have here our angular.json. This is the, let's say it's like the application properties for the front, for the backend application. It's something like that. We have also this package.json file. This is the, like the pom.xml file. So let's check here if the project, yeah. So the project is successfully created. I will open it here. So let's go here, and it's under test, and this is our project. Yeah, this is our project. And as I told you, as we can see here, those are the node modules. They were generated when we saw that Angular is installing the dependencies. The dependencies go here in the node module folder, and we have this src. So first of all, let's check those files. We have, as I said, the angular.json, and here this is the configuration for our project. We have also the package.json, which contains all the dependencies we need. We will need in the project. If we want to add a new dependencies, new dependency, we only need to add it here. So let's see really quick the what we have inside the src folder. We have the app, the assets. The assets is where we can keep all the images and the icons. Here we have the environments. For example, if we need to build an environment for the dev environment, for test, and for the production, we can provide everything here. For example, for the environment, yes. For the moment, nothing is there, and for the production, it's going to be production true. So we have the environments, we have this index of HTML, which is our main page, and here we see that we add the app root. Next we have the styles.scss. Those are the global styles. For example, if I want to create or to add a CSS class that I want to use everywhere, so all I need is to create it here. And next, this is the readme file where we can add some documentation about the project. Okay, so and here in the src we have the app, and in the app we have by default the app routing module, we have the app component HTML, which is our main page, and then we have component CSS and the app module, where we need to add all the declarations, the providers, and the imports. So if we want to use a specific module, all we need to do is to add it here. So now what comes next is, let's open a new terminal here. All we need to do to run the application is just type ng serve. The application is going to be compiled. We will compile all the application, and then we will start the browser on this on the address that will be provided by Angular CLI. So for the moment it's going to be really quick because we do not have anything. So here it says Angular Live Development Server is listening on localhost on the port 4200. Let's copy this address and try it out here. Let's check. So this is our main application. So here test app is running. Those other resources where we have like useful links, for example, how to learn Angular, the CLI documentation, and the blog. And here are some hints. If we want to create a new component, this is the command, ng generate component or ngg component. Angular material, if we want to add or to use Angular material, we only need to use this annotation or this command. For example, to add a dependency, watch tests, and build for production. So this is how we can create an Angular project using the Angular CLI.